count. I didn't make it count. Hold on, let's go and ask one of the guards. We'll run ads in just a moment, but first, I have to just go ask one of the guards if they've heard of a moth priest before. I think there's one down here. Oh yeah, here's one! You know what, you could use your beauty sleep. I'll go ask another one. Savannah? I think we may be a little bit of an impasse. Well, saved it! Yeah, that's a bad one. That's a big yikes. Wait. Did Vats make us invulnerable? Oh my... God damn it! We got done by the flames! Maybe the sacrifice needs to be like, now you have to kill 10 people or something instead of what? Because one, like, look at that. Sacrificed. Didn't even break a sweat.
You there. We're looking for someone in Whiterun.
I don't care. Don't talk to me. Never speak to me or my son ever again. You just deal with him real quick. It's not zooming. Okay, we got him. Another guy. Okay, this is a bad time to reload, but this guy's an idiot. This is how good the AI is! Oh my god, what? He just went and got me straight away. That is the duality of this AI. It's just like, it's just insane for like 20 seconds, and then it's like,
that's a penis.
Excuse me? What are you talking about? Wow. Wowzers, that's a big rock. I resent that. Oh my goodness, what is that? I don't know what you're talking about. Look, it's a little face, look. This is his mustache, and then we're gonna do like a mouth under there or something, I guess. Get your mind out of the gutter, I have no idea what you're talking about. Look at that, beautiful. Don't go up. Why are they going up there? Stop going that way. Guys. You know what? You know what? There's nowhere to go. Turn back now. But other than that, I've heard it's pretty good. Unfortunately, I play on PC, so even if I was going to play it...
For pity's sake, just let us die!
Come on! It's a fun stream! I haven't been talking that much, have I? It's not that bad, is it? Please! It's a bit rough. This is the one? This is the one. Alright, here we go. Here we go, chat. It's time to deliver the final blow to the storm. What if I did this?
Hey, be careful!
Be careful! Yeah, sorry. I'll be more careful. Sorry, I'm really clumsy. This happens all the time. I'm so sorry. I really need to be more careful. Oh, I don't know how this has happened. I'm so sorry.
I must mourn my wife as is proper.
I mean, she literally gave me her scarf to show to him, and I just didn't show it to him. I'm interested.
It was me!
Was it? Alright. Alright, you guys have fun now. I'm leaving.
shouldn't be in here, stranger. You better leave before somebody gets hurt.
Wouldn't want anyone getting hurt.
Would we? Jeez. Again? Again?
That NPC one does not like me. It's just like, as soon as I show up, it's like, get out of here in some way or another. Welcome, everyone. Welcome to the 5-second stream. How you doing? Omega, welcome. Adam, welcome. Superbot, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. What was the E for? Was that like something that happened in one of the clips? I was on the toilet, I didn't see the clips. E. What happened with the E? Stream speedrun? Guys, you wouldn't even understand how good of a speedrunner I am. We started the stream, instantly finished. We don't need to stream anymore. We've speedrun it. We've succeeded. And the stream is concluded. You can all go home. We're done. I just pushed a button and then other people pushed buttons. Well, it's good to know how easily it is to get people to do things. You just press a letter on the keyboard and then everyone has to do that as well.
Fix a 200 près de tout le gain time. That's the second time in a row we end a dance on a NPC and then scream command and the scream gets blocked because it's 200 milliseconds after a dance and the NPC.
Yeah, too slow, Crips. Too slow. You gotta get there quicker. You gotta be on that. You've gotta be on top of that. Adam is a seasoned professional. He is a seasoned mod professional. He knows what's up. He gets it done. You gotta be there before you know that you need to be there. To beat Adam at his game. Thank you for clipping that as well. That was classic. That's gotta be one of the best ones yet, I think. Dev of Netherguild here in the chat for fun times and miserable dungeon deaths. I thought that might have been you. Thank you for the follow. Thank you for the game. It was a very pleasant surprise getting your email. Hoping that we'll do it justice. We'll see how we go. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know really what to expect. I've installed the game. I've opened it up. That's as much as I've done. So this is going to be like complete first impressions. I will clarify before we get in, just so that we're clear. Aside from the fact that it's not like sponsored or anything, I say this at the start of any of the games that I play. Like this, I will be as honest as I possibly can about the game, the things that I like, the things that I don't, but I will try not to be rude about it. I'll try and be constructive. So if the game does something well, I'll definitely say it. If it does something that is not the greatest, I'll probably mention how I think it might be improved, or just don't lie. You know, we don't like
all
liars.
Hail the great and mighty log.
Hail him, thank you for the prayers. I had it typed for a solid minute beforehand. You need 2 minutes beforehand, Crips. You need to be quicker. You need to be on that button. Finger on the pulse. You mentioned feedback, so give me all your constructive criticism. Got my notes ready. That's exactly what I want to hear. That's exactly what we're here for. I've played a few different ones on this. Like our Wednesday slot at the moment, we've had a really nice rotation lately of different indie games that we've had. And we've had a few where I've just been like, yeah, this is amazing. And there's been like one or two little tweaks, and we have had at least one that was tough to sit through, but no one was in that stream anyway, so it was fine, ? Don't worry, I'll try and give notes for sure. Like I said, it's gonna be my first impressions, so it's not gonna be like but number one, it's not going to be filtered by like 3 days of stewing, but number two, it does mean that if I just miss something, then you know, let me know that I've missed it, and then we can readdress it. We've got, and it's Seek Eternal Truths here. Perfect way to start off the stream, I think. Gotta make sure we know, we let the dev know that there's nothing, no funny business going on here, and we can really just settle into, like, just a really chill, casual stream with just nothing weird going on. It, you know, we're just, you know what, let's just do it. Everybody, just have some eternal truths wash over you. Nothing
weird,
though.
They tell you, it is definitely not a cult.
It's not. It's that. That's a disclaimer. Yeah, reminder, thank you. Because we're about to have some truths. By awakening, we self-actualize. Consciousness consists of biofeedback of quantum energy. Quantum means an ennobling of the eternal. We vibrate, reflect, we are reborn. We can no longer live with greed. How should you navigate this sensual world? It can be difficult to know where to begin. Being, look within and develop yourself. Have you found your journey? The galaxy is calling to you via expanding wave functions. Can you hear it? You have never experienced this lightning bolt of the creative act. It can be difficult to live. Nothing is impossible. The stratosphere is radiating sonar energy. Hope is a constant. We exist as atomic ionization.
All hail the great and mighty log.
Now that we've got that cleared up, boom. It's a great place to jump off, a great jumping off point for a stream. Now that everyone knows that we're all on the same level, there's no funny business going on. No funny business, not a cult, chill fun times. Exactly. He gets it. This is where we want to start from, because, you know, sometimes people come in and, you know, they see some hooded figures running around. Hey, Distucky, thank you for the follow, appreciate it. How you doing? Welcome to the stream. They see some hooded figures running around, or, you know, something that's, you know, might seem a little suspicious, and they're like, well, that's a cult. We just like to clarify, before anything, you know, gets out of hand, that there's definitely no cult vibes. That would be really strange. Are you able to kill innocents in your... Oh, yeah, I needed to... That reminds me that I didn't check my channel point redemptions. I have a feeling you probably cannot, so I'm going to turn it off. I'm going to turn off the ones that I'm assuming are not valid in this. There we go. Thank you for... Probably not accidentally, but reminding me. The Council of Buns? There is no cult. Too much paperwork. Exactly. No cult here. Nothing like that. Cult where? No cult. There's way too much paperwork for that. Sacrifices to log? No, I've turned them off. As soon as you mentioned that, Adam, I'm like, oh, I've forgotten to turn the channel point redemptions off again. Because I just have a feeling of how this game is going to play out, even though I haven't really looked at it yet, and that it's not going to allow that sort of redemption, so it's easier if I just turn it off. Anyway, shall we get to the game? Shall we play? Once we get past this screen. One day... Ah, that was close. Second time was close. One day we're gonna nail that. We need another Wilhelm motivation sometime. Oh god, please no. Not like this. So from what I gather, this is a... What is it? It's like, there's a lot of subtitles to this. It's a turn-based, tactical, RPG, rogue-lite dungeon crawler. Is that about cover it? Have I missed anything? Pixel art? Well, kind of. I probably missed something. Nailed it? Good. Professional streamer, you can tell this. Simple boxy characters, cute. Yeah, well, let's just get into it. I'm keen to see how it plays. Three slots, very cool. Far beneath the land, the very ground we walk upon, was the kingdom of Gaia. A brilliant kingdom of engineers and inventors. I don't know why we're changing voices all the time, but...
Who were our greatest allies in the ages past. We aided each other through conquest, trade, and research. Through plague and ruin, through victory and prosperity. However, our friendship shattered.
Sorry. I missed a scene. I'm so sorry. This gave Sin less than a choice path to seal the world forever.
But now, there are rumors of a deadly, gruesome plague of Wesner's outskirts.
On Wesner's outskirts. A pestilent calamity. Oh no, not a calamity. Not like this. That threatens to destroy our kingdom. Thus, 500 years after the sealing of the underworld, the king and his royal council have created the Netherguild. The guild for delving far underground.
They summoned you, a noble, to assemble a team of loyal expeditionaries. Retrieve a cure from our ancient allies. Our only hope.
Obi-Wan, please. Please, Obi-Wan. Everyone pray to Obi-Wan for a second. Welcome to Wesner. Great. Now that I think about it, my favorite thing is 2D sprites on 3D backgrounds. Think Octopath Traveler. Live Alive remake. Time to commit mass murder? Yep, that's right. That being said, I guess only if you do 2D on 3D right. Yeah. It's a nice aesthetic, isn't it? That aesthetic. I think this is... No tutorial! Never any tutorial! Why would we do a tutorial? I think this is more 3D on 3D. But it's gonna look interesting. It's gonna look good, hopefully. Okay, so we can begin our expedition. We can hire new recruits. You can get supplies. We have 75 crowns, and let's hire some people, shall we? Time to suffer. Mm-hmm. Alright, here we go. So we've got a mercenary knight. I want the ranger. I'm not even gonna look at half this stuff because it's gonna make no difference to me at this point. Like, I'm not gonna know what any of it means. So I'm gonna hire... I'm assuming for the first one, I'm basically just gonna hire one of each, because it doesn't look like we have a... Reroll the... Oh no, there is a reroll. Okay. I want a knight. So we've got our tank. I don't want a scout or an assassin though. Oh wait, do they have to be? Oh, is it a case of... Is it a case of that they are just like different guilds or something, but they're always going to be four different classes? No tutorial. That's right. The tutorial's in chat. You are the tutorial. We don't need any other tutorial. Watch me completely fail. All right, let's get some parsnips. All the rest of my money into parsnips. Done. Easy. Easy decision. Let's go. Let's do it. Oh, if recruits can be renamed, are we all on the chopping block? Yes, 100%. Can they be renamed? They can. Yes. I like it already. Okay, everyone. All right. First, we have the Hunter Ranger. First person in gets the name for the Hunter Ranger. Who wants a Hunter Ranger? There are currently four classes, but multiple backgrounds. Gotcha. Shouldn't have said anything. All right, there you are. You said something just then. You are the ranger. Who wants to be the royal guard? Michael Haas. Who wants to be Crips? That's you. Crips. Let me know if you want, like, specific names, by the way.
It's not a sex thing.
It's not. It isn't. You'll be the ass in. Okay. DRF. Oh, wait, is that? Oh, there's no capitalized. That's fine.
Crips a 200 près de tout le gain time. Ça menait ma X-Compies.
As XCOM. I'm trying to remember what your name in XCOM actually is, to be honest. I mean, I could do Crips of the Undying. Do that. I genuinely don't remember what I named your first and last name. Success. You want the Undying? And then we need someone as the Mercenary Knight. Who wants to be the Mercenary Knight? Kylie. So Kylie Crips? Kylie Cripsa? There? That good? There's totally permadeath. Yeah, I bet there is. You'll be the mercenary. Okay, what name do you want? Do you want just... Oh, Super Robot. I've been saying that wrong. Do you want Super Robot, or do you want... What name do you want for the mercenary? Cripsa is an obfuscation of my last name. I see. That makes sense. What is this magic? Hey, monkey, how you doing? This is Netherguild. It's a game. We've got the dev in the chat, Super Robot. We're going to be playing some. It's a turn-based tactical RPG, rogue-lite dungeon crawler. The dev, also known as the tutorial, exactly. As in the dev, right. That's what you were saying, the dev, as in that is the name of his character. Perfect. Of course, that's what you mean. Here we go. You definitely are going to die. Don't you worry about that. I'll think of something to rename my character. We'll go with Subject Omega from now. I'm not sure if we can rename it on the fly, but you're going in... No, you're going to be last. You're the hunter. I can't be that rough. Assassin goes second. There we go. Everything's going to be great. We've got 5 parsnips. Everything's going to be fine. Guys, relax. We're all going to get a parsnip each. And the dev gets a second one because he made the game. He deserves a second parsnip, damn it. Descend. Looks pretty. It looks cute, doesn't it? All right, here we go. We're instantly in. Something immature because I don't need to grow up. I mean, fair enough. That's fair. All right, so... Okay, so Adam is first. Okay, so that's selected there. That's fair enough. Oh! Okay, I wasn't expecting WSAD to actually move my character. That was a misstep by me. I will use the arrow keys. All right, so we have Deep Cut and we have Dagger Storm. That does... Oh, that's a ranged attack. Okay, so let's do this thing because we're in range. Let's get the other knight in here. The Knicket. 4 slashing shield bash. Skips cuts target's turn for 2 turns. Okay. Well, in that case, what we might want to do is we might want to go over here. Shield bash this fella. Bong! That's satisfying. This is the ranger. So you have a piercing shot. 6 piercing. Or a sharp arrow. Boop. There it is. 2-7 range. So that's a shorter range, higher damage. Okay, let's get you up here. Let's go a big old... Oh, an ally. Oh, ow! Stop it! Guys, can you not do that? Let me look at the long list of banned Kahoot names. What? What's that? Oh no, did I just... Oh my goodness. I accidentally just fired. I didn't mean to do that. Oh, ripperoni. I meant to back out first before I did that. Alright, let's just shield bash. These shield bashes are going to be pretty instrumental. Alright, how good is the ranged attack with this guy? So why is it saying that I'm gonna attack an ally? Is that like a fan attack or something? Because of the highlighted tiles. So it attacks all of those tiles. I see. Interesting. Okay, that guy's dead. Oh, bugger. It cycled and I wasn't ready. So the melee ones do the targeted, but the ranged ones... Well, I guess it depends on the ability. Some of them do targeted, some of them do a bunch of them. Because it's... Yeah, I guess it's like a circular one. Okay, that's good to know. Or slashing. Let's give him the old... Yeah, right next to him. Stabberino. Boom! You're dead, son! We got money. Not all, but in an arc. Oh. Is there a way for, like, the UI for it to have, let's say, red all the way around? Or maybe not red, maybe, like, yellow all the way around. This is where it can attack, but then red is where it's definitely going to attack. So that I know specifically where I'm going to attack with that ability. If that's the case that it works like that. Alright, we're just moving now, are we? Yeah, we're just moving through the dungeon. Can I select somebody else? Yes. Oh. We're gonna talk to this dead person? Loot it. Success! What do we get? We got a silver ingot. Well, Adam gets it, I guess. Do I press escape now? Yeah, okay. Who's this dude? A crystal shrimp. Kill it. I guess. Kill it with fire. Oh no, there's another one over there. Okay, I probably should have taken that into consideration. This is my archer. Oh, I see. So it actually highlights a little bit. Okay. Maybe if there was just like a little bit of extra differentiation between that. Like I said, if the other stuff could be... Hey, Franny, how you doing? Welcome, Raiders. Welcome in. Like maybe just like an orange. Like a tinge lower. Like just something to make it a little more obvious. Would be cool. So why am I attacking an ally there? Oh, because that literally is an ally. I thought that was the shrimp. No, that's on me. Welcome in, Raiders. How you doing? Franny, how you doing? What were you playing? We're playing a cool little indie title that the dev is actually in the chat called Netherguild. We're having our first play at it. First impressions. And seeing how it goes. If you are new to the stream, I'm a variety streamer. I do different things throughout the week. A Wednesday at the moment is my sort of indie spotlight, if you will. And this is one of the ones that we've been graciously gifted the code for. And we're trying it out. And so far, too bad. Oh, okay, so it does highlight it. Yeah, just maybe like make the other ones orange or something, just so it's a little more obvious. Wait, did he get hit by that? Or was that from... No, he can't hit that. Let's go over here. There's no, like, disengaging attacks or anything. Like, opportunity attacks. So, seemingly, we can just leave. Thanks for the shout-out. Yeah, did somebody do an actual shout-out? I didn't see it. Did Adam... Did you do an actual shout-out? Or did I just say... Brownie? We played Tears of the Kingdom. Fun night long stream. Oh yeah, how you feeling? How are you liking that is what I meant to say. Bluestone crystal. You know what? You can have that. People say it's quite good. Oh, we can build something? What can we build? A crystal shrimp leg. Alright. You know what? I think you've earned a parsnip. Wait. How do I eat the parsnip? Okay, Google. How to eat a parsnip? Help me skip the tutorial and he's counting on me to make up for it. I mean, that's pretty standard here. That's pretty standard. He forced us on this dungeon crawling adventure, and now Crips, DRF, Superobot, and I are now being sent to our deaths, to our glory. Yeah, glory. Alright, it's combat time. Who have we got here? This is the. So that's the dev. Let's send the dev in first. There's two of them there that I've just now found. I forgot the dev was the ranger. God damn it. Well, ripperoni, my friend. It's gonna be fine. I don't know what you guys are worried about. Alexa, so you need to buy logs to build bonfires to rest and eat. If only I had bought logs instead of 10 parsnips. If only there was a way of knowing. If only there was some kind of tutorial that I could have done to find this information out. It's fine, we got Shield Bash. We got two characters with Shield Bash. We'll be absolutely fine. Wait, that's me, you absolute idiot? Is it? Oh yeah, that was you. I thought the other person was selected. Oh well, you survived. Toughen up. Look, you're gonna give him the old... Bippity boppity. It's just... It just happens. It's just... It's like out of habit. It's force of habit. Sending Omega straight in. Boom. What are you guys worried about? We didn't even take any damage.
So good at games.
You're damn right. Relax. We survived fine. Oh, is this like the exit? Go deeper. Oh, there we go. Subject is the ranger. Yeah, I thought I had yours selected for some reason. So we can get inventory. How do I eat the parsnip? Loving Tears of the Kingdom. Any time spent in the world of Breath of the Wild is pretty magical for me, and I'm overjoyed to have it essentially refreshed with all new stuff to explore and discover. Yeah, that's what I've heard from most people that are into it. So I'm glad you're enjoying it. That sounds great. Oh wait, that doesn't even... Oh no, it restores 4 health. Consumed next to a built bonfire. Okay. Who'd have thought that if I just read the text, it tells me what I need to know. Wild. Absolutely wild. I swear he just sends me in these missions to die. No. Perish the thought. I wouldn't do that. That would be silly. Oh, here we go. Build a bonfire with logs and you eat it. Wait, you eat the bonfire? Yikes. If only I'd bought logs. If only I'd brought our Lord and Savior along. Now, here we go. Look at this. Boom. Actually lining up one of my attacks for once. Oh, there's more of them. There's bloody more of them. I can get a good piercing shot here, though. If I... this is actually kind of awkward. I'm going to move you there because I want to get this pierce shot. I think I'm just going to have to end turn view. So let's go down here. I didn't realize that I have a specific amount of them. Well, this is going to get dicey. What is reading? Don't know. Sounds like a nerd thing to do. Let's give the old clobbering. Oh, you know what? That's probably got cooldowns and stuff as well, or like certain amounts.
Oh, for the love of Akatosh, would everyone just please calm down? I'm fine, and I don't need anything. I just wanted to talk. That's all.
I do wish everyone would calm down a bit, yeah, to be fair. Oh, they bleed out? Oh, see. Right, let's go here. Let's get the old stab. Boom. Just everyone crowd around and stab this boy to death. Yeah, 2 out of 3. Okay. Yeah, probably should have realized that at some point. Boom! We got it. Easy. My fire is ready. Wait, you've got a fire? I need a fire. Limited ammunition honestly makes sense for a ranged class. Well, it's actually... Oh, yes! Another parsnip! It's actually all of them. So, these abilities... have, like, a limited amount of charges. I don't know how it works with, like, you know, if there's a way to change that in any way. Like, get more at some point. Okay, now we don't need to attack these guys. But we are going to... Can I get, like, a good... No, because I've used them all. So instead, let's get Adam in here. That's not Adam, is it? Adam was the assassin. That's the whole point. Job on track. You've done it. Let's get... Nope, that's not going to work. Let's put Omega in the way of this dude so that our tank can't get hit, question mark? Seems a solid logic to me. It's right, he's going to tank for that one. Ow. Bleed. Not bleed. There we go. Take that! Resource management is also big here. Bonfires restore attack uses as well. That makes sense. If only we'd bought something other than parsnips. Is there a way to get logs? Outside of, in the dungeon. Is that something that I might also pick up during the dungeon dive? Okay, there we go. That one's down. So the bonfire... our parsnip collection grows larger. Wouldn't have it any other way. So the bonfire, aka the great and mighty log, is really important thing. Exactly! Our Lord and Savior, as usual, very important. So glad I attacked these guys that I just clearly did not need to. I don't think I even got anything out of doing it. I'm so glad that I did that. Okay, what's in here? Is that dynamite? Yeah, well, it's an explosive barrel. And this is a shrine to the gods of the underworld. Stand and gaze at the shrine. This crystalline figure holds pickaxe and a torch in his lid. You know what? Sure. To speed! Woo! Inspired navigation. You might find some, but you might not. All comes down to luck. Oh, okay. So that means, in other words, we won't find some. If I know my luck, and I do, we will not find them. This is Adam. Yeah, send him in. Send him in. Get in there, son. Slap that bandit. I really wish that the ranger and the rogue weren't first, so that I could actually get the tanks in. Okay, luckily we have enough to deal with them. So that's pretty easy. Oh! Did not know that guy was there. You can return to the overworld at the top right at any point out of combat. Is it that? I mean, we can't... it might be different because we're in combat right now, but... glorious parsnips. Parsnips are the lifeblood. I mean, you guys would be seeing some real dividends if those parsnips... if we had have brought a campfire, like some logs along with those parsnips. Look, we got a turkey leg as well. The funny thing is, we're actually kind of loaded to heal all of this health. We just don't have anywhere to sit down and eat them. That's our real problem. Okay. Almost. Ooh, new bow. New bow for Omega. I'm gonna still take this bow though. I'll get rid of it if I don't need it later. I was wondering if... Okay, cool. If games ever allow you to start religions, I'm making a nature-based one, the daily ritualistic sacrifice to log, but it's fine because it's labeled under religion. It's not a cult, shut up. Yeah, exactly. You're in pain? Oh, what do you mean? You've got 5 health left. You'll be fine. Should we attack these shrimp again? We could. Let's see what's on the other side first before we decide if we're going to attack the shrimp just completely randomly. A flipped mine cart. You stumble upon a flipped mining cart. Doesn't seem too heavy. It's stuck between a few blue stone crystals. Looks like something shining below it. This is a bad idea. Flip it. You do some stretches. Very good. Prepare properly and try to flip it. It's a tough and straining job, but you end up succeeding. Below the cart, you discover absolutely nothing. Besides more shiny bluestone crystals. However, this ends up being great training. You feel much stronger and more confident after managing to flip the cart, and you get 4 experience. Great success. Great success. Hello there. Hello there. Okay, Adam's first again, so... you know what? I should actually maybe not send him straight in this time. He's just gonna chill down here. Omega, on the other hand. Oh. Do I have no line of sight? Is there... Is that a wall? It's a bit tricky to tell. Oh, I can shoot through there. Set him in there. Give him the old slap and tickle. And then... Crips comes in to finish the job off. Boom. Got him. That is indeed a wall. It was a wall after all. It was a wall. It is a wall. Oh, they're not dead yet. Oh, that's sad. Let's bring Adam up now. End his turn. Can we get a shot from here? Yes, we can. Hey, we've got the tanks up front for once. That's a novel idea. No, nobody would have thought it possible. Ow! My face! Is there any plan to add any extra complexity to the combat, i.e. things like parries, something like an Overwatch-style ability, or an attack of opportunity, or anything extra like that? Or do you prefer keeping it simple? Which, by the way, is definitely not a loaded question. I'm legitimately curious which way you're planning on going. Because I'm a sucker for a good Overwatch, but it doesn't have to be in every game. As much as I would love an Overwatch. Okay. Boom! Dead. Got him. Got him, coach. We got more food that we can't eat. Yay! We're gonna have so much food. We got a silver ingot as well. We're actually gonna be full. Cool. We got so much stuff. Can we like, surely we can like sell it at the market when we leave or something? All right, we made it. Okay, and there is more this way. Very cool. Okay, Omega's first. Ooh, he's got fire arrows now. Is that because he's got a new weapon? Are the charges, like, connected to the weapons? Oh, man, he's on fire. Okay, we're right next to the exit. I'm going to send in Adam right now. Right when we could just about get out of here without having anyone die. I'm going to make sure someone dies. I mean, what? Oh, it's his turn. Okay, we want to get you up here. Oh, I forgot. He's the one that doesn't have a shield bash. Oh, I'm so glad he attacked there instead of Adam. He just somehow survived. If I die, I'm queuing to go back in. And as a ranger, nonetheless. Alright, good. Sounds good. Starts out simple, but there's more complex stuff later on, like blocking and the like. Okay, cool. Good to know. No Overwatch, though, for this one. Yeah, that's fair. Overwatch would really only work for the ranger. What are you going to do? Throw your sword at them? No, so what they generally do in a game similar to this, with this sort of style, for like an Overwatch mechanic, for a melee unit, is you have what's called an attack of opportunity. If anyone passes by your sort of cone or your influence, any like single tile around you and leaves, they try to run away, you get a free attack. All right, you stab him. There's a lot of games, especially like CRPG style games that do an attack of opportunity. Good at the moment. Yeah, but be careful with fire, it spreads. I did see that guy was on fire. I didn't realize. He was snapping you. He's fine. Look, he's got 2 health left. We don't need more than 2 health. Look, the threat is dealt with. Everyone's fine. You people need to stop stressing out. Everything's fine. Okay, so we can just return to the overworld, right? New skills unlocked. Ooh. Ooh. Here we go. I'm gonna look at that in a sec. Okay, except the range, just more well ranged. Yeah. I enjoy not being on the front lines, question mark. Yeah, Adam was this time. Levels up. Yep. We got him. So do we choose? Is this like XCOM style where we choose one of the two? I still have at least 1 HP. I'm good. Yeah, exactly. You're not dead. So relax. Consider yourself blessed. It's 2 HP. Twice as much as you need to be alive. So I don't know what you're whining about, honestly. Okay, hold on. Kneel for the crown. Gain attack, kneel for the crown. It's got a cooldown of 3 and it's got max uses 3. We have Fortress Stance. Wait, hold on. So this pushes targeted enemy 3 tiles away. +3 damages when attacking from behind. And this blocks first attack until next turn. You know what? I'm going to go kneel for the crown. Okay, very cool. Yeah, okay, so I have to do it for each of them. Yep. Who's this? This is Adam the Damned. So the guillotine is a free action, doesn't end the turn. You know what? I like the sound of that. I'm not even going to read the rest of it. Free action? I'm there. Oh. The dev didn't get a level up, neither did Omega. Well. Too bad for you. Look at all this stuff. Look at all the parsnips. Guys, the parsnip meta. You won't even believe the parsnip meta. One noble standing, one commoner standing. Okay. We got a silver ingot. Okay, hold on. Bluestone crystal amulet. Bluestone crystals are known to have medical and healing properties. However, in order to harness these qualities, the crystal will have to be refined. Walking past the market and contemplating this, you spot a friendly trinket merchant. Hearing your plight, he offers to refine the crystal into an amulet. However, the worker materials will cost him 5 crowns. I got plenty of money, so that's fine. What does an amulet do? I guess we're going to find out. Let's find out. Okay. We'll
have a look in a little bit.
So I'm assuming everyone heals once we go back to the village, right? I've got barely any experience. You did a fair bit of shooting as well. Maybe you just didn't get the kills on anyone. Ooh, we can buy equipment. Okay. I want a crossbow. Cozy armor. Okay, I'm going to buy a crossbow for Omega. And that's a mace. Is that better? Melee attack, strength plus 1 slashing damage. Oh, it inflicts bleed, so... Nah, I'd rather get you armor, actually. Let's see what's in the warehouse. Oh, this is all our stuff? Okay. Very cool. Okay, let's buy some logs this time. I left just enough money to be able to buy some. I almost forgot. Can we plant the parsnips and grow more? Gotta get all those parsnips. Start a new economy with parsnips. What is this? Animal Crossing? I mean, I'm down for that, but... Oh, I didn't realize we could actually get one more member. We're actually 4 out of 5. We could have gotten one more person. We could have gotten... Probably a scout would have been good. Oh, you know what? Did I just buy a bow that I can't use... for, Omega? Can he only use... bows? Like... Yeah, that's... Oh, no, he can use it, but it slows him down. Yeah, he got the upgraded one anyway. Oh well. We've got a weapon we can't use. Sick. Now I have a medieval gun. Sadly not. So we'll be able to sell the parsnips for profit. This is true. We do have a lot of parsnips. Yeah, let's sell the parsnips for profit. Can we sell the parsnips? Can we sell things? Sells food and general use supplies. So it doesn't look like they buy them though. Selling is kind of awkward right now. It's a warehouse upgrade, but I'll add it at some point, I promise. Okay. It would be nice if you could buy and sell at the market. Just that extra flexibility and less difficult to understand. Yeah, I needed that extra person. Oh well. Oh, I didn't realize we could select. You know what? Sure, select them both. Let's do it. Bluestone mines. Okay. The dev's going in first this time. Crypt's behind that. Omega at the back. No. Alright, parsnips ahoy. We're gonna use some of these damn parsnips. Logs. Adam can have log. Let's get some of these more parsnips. Okay, the armor I need to actually put on someone. I'm going to give the armor to the dev. What's this? Crystal shrimp leg. Oh, yeah, we can eat that. Okay, I don't want too much stuff, otherwise we won't be able to pick anything up. Need to actually apply some of this. You can equip your guys by right-clicking. Well, I can do that. There we go. Oh! Is that supposed to go on someone else? Medium armor. That's for the assassin? Easy to relax in. Requires medium armor proficiency. It might also be nice to have, like, some extra... Like, there's a decent amount of information in here, but, like, in this sort of empty area... I can't really point at the screen, but... Because it disappears. But in the empty area up there, if there was, like... classes that the weapons and armor and stuff was more like designed for, and because I think you can still use it on other classes, but it gives you a debuff or something. So having the information about that in the UI would be nice. Here we go. Alright, so Adam's first. He survived the one health last time, so let's get him straight in. Okay, so he's got the guillotine. He's got the dagger storm. Interesting, so it's like a long range. Okay, I'm trying to remember that. Who's this? This is Omega. Oh, with his nice new crossbow. Oh, wait. Oopsie daisy. Oh, damn it. Rude. I'll have you for that. He's gonna get a shot. Rip. Noted, it shows it in the character panels, but that gets obscured by the hover text. Yeah. Okay. I mean, there's always, like, there's always a bunch of just, like, little things that you just... Especially as the person working on the game, because you know all of these things, like, you know how the game plays, you just don't necessarily notice some of the extra stuff. Because you're like, oh, well, I do the thing by doing that, because, you know, you designed the game. So you know that. Oh, wow, we've already... place we can go down. Hey, heels! Sick. Alright, what's up this way? Alright, who's this? Who are we going first? Adam? Cut her up. Stabby, stabby. We really need to get you a better weapon. And this should be Omega. Also, another nice thing would be... With fear of overcrowding the UI a little bit, something that, like, that classically, obviously, XCOM does is... I know it's on the side here, but, like, if just above the character, it had their name, like, if I've got... Now I've got use... I've got the dev selected, I've got you selected. If just a little... Even if it's just, like, the first name, a nickname or something, the... And then the little shield symbol to denote what class it is, just so I can, at a glance, be like, okay, that's who's selected, that's who I've got, like, that's what I'm working with, would probably be a nice little... We'll just make it a tad easier. Alright, let's give him a little stab. There we go. Easy. Can I shoot from there? No. Oh, also... I know I'm giving a lot of note. None of this is bad. This is actually something that's been pissing me off in XCOM Enemy Unknown. Not in this game, but I'm mentioning it now because it's such a good thing that they added in the later installments that, and I don't know how exactly it would be implemented in this specific setting, but having a way to see your line of sight on the squares you're about to go to is like super useful, but it does get a little bit more tricky when you've got different abilities that hit in different regions and stuff, so it might not be as, it's probably not as straightforward as that. But that's definitely one thing that's helpful. But yeah, like I said, it's probably a lot more difficult to implement than that, because then you have to take into consideration several other things. Should we fight the shrimp? Definitely plan to redesign the health bars, but unsure when I'll get to it. Yeah, no, that's fine. I understand that, for sure. And like I said, it's not... None of this is game-breaking stuff, or like... makes me think, oh... this game's not very good or anything. It's just little things to help improve the quality of life. Because quality of life improvements, especially if there's like already a relatively decent amount of content, quality of life improvements can be the make or break. Like, if you've got like a banger of a game, but it's super obscure and obtuse to play, it can make it like not matter how much content there is, because it's just awkward to play. But if you've got a bunch of just like quality of life stuff, it can really help that experience. Alright, we got those dudes. Easy. Easy clap. We're gonna take their tail. Boom. Now we're almost full. Alright, well, we can go down another layer then. Easy.
Let's go deeper!
I'm basically just the support class, come to think of it.
Yeah.
You're just sitting back there with little bow, just peppering them from a distance. Oh, someone got a level up. The dev got a level up. Rally, probably never use that. Fortress stance. Oh, two additional accuracy for two turns. I'm not gonna lie, didn't realize you could miss. Have I just been really lucky so far? Is there something that tells me the amount of like chance that I have to hit or miss? Let's go fortress stance. Let's see what that does. And Crips still doesn't still didn't get a level. Poor Crips. Crips is just hanging out for that level. Shadow Empire, which I like, is kind of like that. Obscure but fun. Yeah, which, don't get me wrong, for some people is actually the selling point. But you'll find for a large portion of people having like that nice, those nice quality of life features can really like help sell a game. Do I want to kill the... You know what? Yes. Kneel before the crown. Accuracy is range damage. Oh. Is it? That might be... a slightly... confusing term to have for ranged damage for some people. Probably just me, because I am an idiot. But the accuracy generally would mean... Oh, he just ignored it. Wow, okay. You would generally think of the accuracy as your chance to hit rather than the amount of damage that it does. I'm already level 2? No? Oh, are you? Was it somebody else that didn't level up? It's definitely confusing. Also, it was nice knowing you. Ah, you'll be fine. Relax. Relax. Yeah, I'm gonna... Oh, actually I can get... Yeah, I can get just those two. Good. And meanwhile, Omega's just chilling at the back here. You know what? Set that dude on fire. Do it. Ow! Ow! Oh, who's that? That's Crips is getting all the hits, actually. Alright, let's do a slap there so that they stop moving for a sec. Oh, everyone's on fire! Crips is gonna die. Can we do a shot over to this dude? Oh. Interesting. Oh, right! Free action! I forgot about that. And then let's do a stab into the big crystal shrimp. The Flamin' Werfer! It worths a Flamin'! That's it. That's the one. It worths that Flamin'.
Ça 200 près de tout le gain time. I am not going to die because alternate timeline exists.
Not this time. Yeah, I probably should have pushed him back. I don't know if you get an alternate timeline in this one, Crips. Bonk. Oh, we did a block. Yep. There goes Crips. Can we get some F's in the chat for Crips? Once again, we attacked these guys when we just absolutely did not need to. Oh, this one. And we have paid the price. Well, Crips has paid the price. Everyone else is fine. Alright, let's kill that one. Should I get... I'm gonna hit that one. More people are probably gonna die. Ow! Everything's fine? We're gonna survive. I mean, I knew when I attacked this thing that it was probably going to kill me. Yet for some reason I attacked it all the same. All right, we need to kill. Oh, we can't even hit that. I struggle to understand what the range, what the arc of that is. Oh, 3 to 7 range. Is that what the thing is? Oh. Who's that? Somebody else just died. Well. Ironically, Omega and Adam are the ones that are still alive. The dev died? Yep. Ripperoni? Omega is the only one that survived. Amazing. How is Omega the one that survived? Oh no, we don't have any space for anything. You know what? Get rid of all the parsnips. Just take the jewels. Oh, sure. These are probably worth more than that. Oh wait, is this the big one? Yeah, big leg. Okay, we'll get rid of small leg for big leg, I guess. Aren't you guys glad that we stopped to fight that thing? New skill! You finally got your level up! All it took was everybody else dying! Isn't that great? Let's do that one. Not even gonna read it, just gonna do it. Oh no, I should have just pressed the leave button. There's like 3 or 4 of them. What does this do? Extra damage to a target at max health. Okay, done. and there's more of them. I thought the exit was here. Can I actually... Is there a way to leave? We got out. We got out. We did it. This is kind of a game over since there's not enough money to recover. Is there not? Oh no. We got 40 bucks. It might not be game over. We can recover from this. But the embassy. So this is our standing with everyone. We can hire all new people. It's fine. Don't even worry about it. We can get... There we go. Everything's fine. You know what? We'll even hire the last person. Now we've got 5 people. Like nothing ever happened. Straight back in we go. There we go. I know what you guys are worried about. Everything's fine. Okay, assassin needs to go there. Can we not take everyone at once? Is it only 4 at a time? Oh, yeah. So does the last person stay at home? Well, in that case, I want to at least take someone different. Like a scout. I haven't tried a scout yet. We've still got some parsnips. Bless. We've got the scout. The crossbow, rather. Oops. Then here we go. Here we go, chat. We don't have the logs still. We can't make a bonfire, but let's bring Crips the Dev and DRF back. Yeah, I think that. Yeah, true. Oh, I might not be able to. I might have missed my opportunity. Press I. There. I'm gonna assume... Oh, it's like a... siege crossbow? It's less speed? I don't know. It'll be fine. Always 4. Okay. Sorry, I need to check my phone. There was a notification on it. Okay. Not needed immediately. Good. Yeah, I don't think I can... I can't rename them once I'm already in, can I? I had to rename them previously, didn't I? That's unfortunate. If they survive, you guys will get the names. Light it up. Not yet. Fair enough. You get bigger parties later on, is it always 4? It's always 4. Alrighty then. Who is this? This is Omega's first. Let's stand him right next to the flammable barrel and see what happens. I'm sure that can only end in good things. Abbo. Come on, Abbo. Okay, this is probably Adam. Because he was the assassin last time. That's a big old crip slap. And the scout can be the Dev, I reckon. How strong is this siege bow? Knockback. Very nice. I actually prefer having one of the ranged units getting less speed anyway, because it means they go last. Which means I can position them a little better. There we go. We lost a tiny bit of health, but otherwise we're all good. Some food, which we can't eat. Now, should we fight the shrimp again? It worked well last time. Good luck getting below the third floor, by the way. Sounds like a challenge to me. Down we go. It shoves? Yeah, there was a nice little bit of knockback there on that bow. Alright. Who is first? Abbo, get in there. Come on, Adam, show them what you're worth. Show them what for. And this is Omega. I am gonna go just a normal cheeky rooty tooty McShooty. What's his turn now? Oh wow, they really just want to focus down this fella. This is we picked up a parsnip. Okay, good. I'm so glad we've picked up a parsnip. Oh, it's a siege shot. Wow, okay, so it's like a limited thing. So like it's pretty hectic, but it's not an infinite one. Interesting. Guys, have faith. Come on. Have faith. Everything will be fine. I mean, it really doesn't help that our tank has lost so much health already. We don't have a siege shot anymore, so we're gonna have to send you into stab. Ow! Take that, Devinald. Alright, stab. Crowd around him and stab him in the throat! Got him. Easy clap. Stop messaging me! Hold on, I need to check it again. It wasn't... It's a thing. Okay. Do we have anything to pick up? Oh, this was a dead end room. So, I'm assuming... Especially by the fact that this is like a roguelite, I'm assuming that are these all these like dungeons and stuff procedurally generated, or is there like a specific layout? Oh, we got a pickaxe. I don't know what we can use that for. We'll figure it out. Oh, we found someone. Who's first? Omega is. Absolutely all procedural. I mean, it makes sense. I've said this a couple times on stream, but it makes a lot of sense for especially like indie developers to do a lot of procedural stuff and roguelite stuff, because it means that they can focus. You can spend a little bit of time like making those, well, probably a decent amount of time making those procedures for it to then generate things, but then you can spend more of your time making the actual gameplay solid. Right, let's get that guy. Ooh, we're hurting now. I reckon I can stand here and get both of them. Yeah, we can. Alright, I might do a slap here, otherwise we might not make it out alive. Come on. Boom! See you later! He's out of here, and then he bled out. Cool. He bled out in the darkness. Every dive is different to the last. Yeah. Just really love procedural things. It makes it replayable. Procedural generation also means more replayability. Yeah. I mean, there is definitely a point where you have to be careful with that, because the after playing the same thing a number of times, it can end up being more, it can feel more copy and pasted of like the exact same thing that you've just had, rather than a new experience. But when balanced correctly, it definitely adds some extra replayability and stuff. But it depends on the scale, it depends on the implementation, it depends on a lot of things. But definitely, especially for like an indie dev or a small dev team, it's a very powerful tool to be able to procedurally generate stuff. Experience. Which way are we going? This way? If only there was a pickaxe. I've got the pickaxe. How do I use the pickaxe? I thought it would just like... Do I have to like have the specific person? Oh, there we go. I have to have the specific person on it. Gold! I like gold! Do we break the pickaxe doing that? Bonzi bastards. Okay, we really want to be... Wow, look at all those crowns. They're bloody everywhere, son. And we got a new crossbow. It's a quick crossbow. Hmm. 2-2. Accuracy plus piercing damage. Maximum use is 14. And it does also push the target. Plus one initiative. I mean, I'll take it. If nothing else, it will mean a backup. Wait, where am I putting it? Oh yeah, there it is. Seat's crossbow, yeah, okay. F for Mr. Pickaxe. No more pickaxe. Alright, here we go. What level are we on? We're on floor 2. Our gun collection grows larger by the hour. We've got like 3 crossbows. Alright, we're gonna try and do floor 3. But if things get too hairy, we may just yeet. Ooh, a new bow. A killer's bow. Alright. You got a new bow, Omega. I didn't actually check to see if it was any better, but you've equipped it now, so guess we'll find out in the heat of battle. What's this? Stand and gaze at the shrine. Oh, speed. Okay, cool. Here we go. Sniping's a good job, mate. Yeah. I mean, out of the classes that are available in this game, it would be my favorite. It would be my choice of class as well. Okay, this isn't ideal. Oh, we can do a shot through there. Stealthy shot, here we go. 1 damage! I probably should have read it, hey. Probably should have read what it said on it. Oh no, there's 2 of them here. Let's get you right in there. What could go wrong with this? Who's this? This is... Oh, this is the dev. Okay. Let's do a cheeky... Brap! And then let's get you down here. Kill him off, so he's gone. And then just get shot in the face. Adam's gonna die twice. Not even gonna get to rename to Adam. Just gonna die before it even gets there. Yeah. Oh no, they've decided to go over here. Oh no, the dev's taken a beating as well. How many of them are there? Okay, I'm not gonna lie. I thought we might have been okay. I did not realize there was like 6 of them in here. What's the range on that? 3-5? Alright, we'll do a stab then. Ripperoni! Okay, let's get straight up there. Start slapping. Crips is so gonna die. becoming... We might try and yeet. Can we yeet? We got out! We managed to leave. 33% chance we managed to do it. We did not think this through. I thought it through, I just didn't think there was going to be six of them in the one room. We have a remember, Steve. I saw that from, I only just saw that now. Let's everyone take a moment to remember the people that have died. Somehow we did make it out of that alive. But the dev who died previously, I mean, everyone except Omega has died once. Somebody else just died a second time, which I think was... Who was it that just died? Oh, it was Adam. Adam's died twice. RIP. It's fine. Everything's fine. You guys need to have faith. I don't know why. I've clearly proven that you don't. You shouldn't have. Okay, we need to make sure we have some logs with us. Let's see if there's anything at the armory we can get. Ooh, another crossbow. Some armor. A purging dagger. Okay, I want a better dagger. Oh, why did I do that? We don't have a... Oh, well, I suppose I can put it on the... One of the hunters. I'm gonna buy that one. One of the... Scouts, I mean, I'm gonna put on the scout. Okay, we're gonna name everyone. At this point, I'm already a grizzled war veteran, traumatized knowing my friends have sacrificed themselves. You're like the only one that's still here. Alright. How long is the... Oh, no. I'm just gonna say... There we go. Oh, can I not do numbers? Oh, I can't do numbers. Okay, we'll just do that then. Scout is now gonna be Adam. Oh wait, no, that was, sorry, that was the dev. Adam will be the ranger, because that's all that's left. RIP. Oh, hold on. Alright, let's go back in. Barren balance, open multiple pods by accident. Yeah, I just didn't expect there'd be so many. Alright, we're gonna bring some logs. We're gonna bring a dagger. What happened to all my food and stuff? I don't remember actually using it. Was it all on the person that died? Surely not. Did I leave it in the, No, that's the warehouse there. I don't know how we lost it all. The only reason I'm alive is because my weapon of choice is a bow. Yeah, you best believe it, Sunshine. Alright, we've got a new dagger. For you. If background is not Inquisitor. What's an Inquisitor? I'm assuming that's... What is the negative of that? You know what? I don't care. I'm going to give them those weapons even though they're not class specific. It'll be fine. Halo theme in the background fitting well for this. This and like the Skyrim theme, which plays every now and then, can work pretty well. Oh, I guess we're going down straight away. Easy. Easy level, easy floor, we did it! Straight away in combat. Time to make a character for me. Sorry Claire, I didn't realize you wanted one in, otherwise I would have replaced one of the people that had already been in before. If you flee, it discards inventory. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, this is Omega first up. You can just do a big old rap rap eye piercing. Oh, this guy's got only that. Okay. I love that. Boom, just disappears off screen entirely. Alright, let's see how this goes. Fire. Do fire. I don't think we're gonna get very far. Hey, Fashion Chops, how you doing? Welcome. 13 viewers, is that how many people are in? Well, we did get raided earlier on, and we got raided with like 16 people, so that's actually pretty low, and I'm very sad. That's... We can't keep the people around. Yeah, whatever. I'm having fun. So what is the deal with this one? +3 when attacking from behind. Okay. So not actually that tasty. Headshot, though. Legit. This is not gonna be great. Wait, where's the... Who has the other bow? Oh, wait, no, is it that bow? Well, we scuffed it, because this is the ranger? That's fine, I'll just wait there. I want to see how this Inquisitor knife does. Yeah. It looked impressive, but it wasn't. Didn't even seem to actually burn them. Bonk. Last time we used fire, it didn't go so well. No. That's fake news. Fake news. How close? It's 2-6, isn't it? This is gonna be awkward to use. Well, that counts as a flank. Okay, sure. I'll take that. Is there anything that we need to rearrange? It probably doesn't matter that they've got -2 initiative, so that's probably fine. Let's take that. And that. Very cool. Now, it would do better on an assassin, though. Yeah. Yeah, I had a feeling that was the case. If Adam was still alive. Oh, we don't have a pickaxe. Hello? Well, we lit up the room and we saw the enemy. Alright, let's try and get a nice cheeky headshot in. We can't. Omega, please. There we go. Crap. Slap. Okay, we need one more person. One more person in the pileup. Sharp arrow piercing. Wait, does that one do... No, it's just normal. Okay, let's just do that. Boop. They've got another person back. Oh, he's just disappearing into the void. Oh, whoever that... Rips is gonna die again. Rips is gonna get real hurt. Oh, not the fire. We probably shouldn't use fire at all. Alright. Stealthy shot, here we go. 4. And stab, dead. Okay. We need to find the person that disappeared into the darkness. Oh, they're not here. What? If I knew how to make a good guard system like in Digimon... If I knew how to make a guard system like in Digimon Survive, I'd definitely make a flank-based weapon. Is this for, wait. Were you the one that was also working on a game? Like in RPG Maker or something? I can't remember if that was you or not. Put out the fire, easy clap. It's just easy. Just so good at this. So close. Okay, can't seem to do anything there. Guess I don't have enough range. Alright, headshot time. Oh, 7! That is brutal. Okay, let's give him the old rap rap. Easy. Too easy. Too easy. No, totally not, wasn't me. You're just remembering wrong. Well! Too bad. Question mark. Oh, there's the pickaxe. For a second, I thought that was a legitimate rocket launcher. It's not, but it should still do some extra damage, I guess. What a pickaxe. Okay, how do we use the bonfire? How do we do a bonfire? Spinning bludgeon pog. Ooh, here we go. That sounds fun. How do we set up the bonfire? Do I have to like select the person that has the thing? Oh, new skill. Rally. Nah, let's go fortress. Does anyone else have a level? Special logs made from firewood. It burns bright, heats well, and emits smoke. You just build it. Oh, you're right. That's what the build button is for. Yep. Yeppers. Is there like a specific spot I'm supposed to put this? Does it have to have all that space around it? Otherwise it won't build? Yeah. Go back to where we were before. Go back into this big open room. There we go. Gather round! Deconstruct? What's this? Rest. Everyone's taking a nap. And now we get the inventory? Okay. So, do I have to like... Oh, eat! There's an eat button down there. It's just a little small. Oh, I don't go into the inventory. I just do eat. Do I not have any other... God damn it! We're already out of parsnips! We got some health back. Now, where was that? Okay. Who has the pickaxe? You? Who has it? Use pickaxe. Gold! Did we even get the gold back last time, or did we just lose? It does require empty space. So the way it works in Digimon Survive is that at the end of a character's turn, you're able to lock in a certain direction to defend themselves. The front gets good defense, the sides get okay defense, and the back gets un. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. That's relatively standard in a sort of tactical style as well. Yeah, there's a bunch of other games that do that. That makes more sense. Go deeper. If only we invested in Parsnips Gang. Look, if Parsnips Gang hadn't have died, we literally did invest in Parsnips Gang. It's just that they died. Oh, here we go. Oh, there's a bunch of them there. Seven. That thing is legit. Can we get on that? No, not much. Yeah, we might die again. Spinning bludgeon. Is this gonna hit everyone? No. Get him. Now, just hope that he doesn't walk next to the explosive barrel. Ow! Someone's gonna die. Explosive barrel opportunity? Yeah, how do we... I'm kind of wondering if we sacrifice. Can we hit the... Does it have to be with fire? No, it doesn't look like we can... shoot anyone else. Two piercing? Yikes. They have a piercing shot. Yeah, I thought someone did. Oh, please tell me that's... That's fine. There we go, that should work. There we go. Hey, he stole my gold! Oh, now this guy's gonna die. Fortress stance. Here we go. Here we go. Survive, mother trucker. Everything's fine. Actually, don't watch out for friendly fire. Well, I was contemplating sacrificing Rip to get that shot in. Because it would have done some big damage. Wait, what's happening here? Oh, there we go. I think I'm going to spend it on him, because it will do... as much as I wanted. Can we get a shot from there? Yes, we can. Oh, two! Alright, this is risky. But we're gonna go up, I'm gonna slap him. And then... shot over here. Yes! Good! He burned to death. That's what I was hoping. That was risky. Saved. One health. Oh, there's a dead person here. Loot it. Oh. Ow. We really need that exit. Okay. We are not going to attack these people. I am not going to take their eggs, because that is definitely going to wake them up and have them... Well. Can I blow that up? Does that work? Do I have to use a fire weapon, or can I use any of these weapons? Like, if I hit it with the sneaky snack, will that blow it up? Any works? Perfect. I've been betrayed! It didn't damage it at all! I've been swindled! Was it not strong enough? What about this one? Ooh, that's not bad. His sneaky requires back damage? Oh. Oh. Right. They have to go first, so... Crips, you're going into your death. Knock that dude into the next dimension. Alright, let's hit that. Let's get that explosive. Boom! Six damage? Oh yeah, that guy still exists, doesn't he? Okay, let's get... I kind of want to put it on him. We need to get him hurt. Let's do just a normal sharp arrow on that guy. Get him dead. That yeet was hilarious. Okay, can I... Again, this is risky, but I need I need to stun that person. Where's the... Alright, let's get a fire on him. Yeah, please don't shoot at Crips. Someone just died. Hey, they didn't shoot at Crips. Crips survived. Alright, just kill. Just kill the big hammer bandit. That hammer was savage. Okay, good. He's still stunned for one more turn.
Which way is he facing?
Another thing that might be nice to be able to sort of figure out where everyone's facing. Like, I can zoom in and find out. But some way of... Like a very like translucent cone for their line of sight or something. I don't know exactly what the solution would be, but a way without like zooming in to figure out which way they're facing would be kind of nice. Let's go up here. Two. It's all right. We'll get the final slap in. We survived. Well, most of us did. You can zoom and rotate with Q and E. Yeah, I don't know about you. I don't know who else does this. But for me, like, it's good to have. Don't get me wrong. It's absolutely good to have. It needs to be there. But whenever I play a tactical, like an isometric tactical game, there is only one orientation. Actually, it happens in city builders and stuff as well. You can rotate the camera, but whatever it's set to originally, or whatever has me... Well, yeah, it's usually whatever it's set to originally. It has to be, like, it has to be that. Rotating the camera around just feels wrong. So, I just don't end up doing it. It's only if there's, like, situations where I literally, like, can't see through, like, there's walls in the way or something, and I actually can't see what I need to see, that I'll end up rotating. But usually I'll just keep it as the one. Oh, no. Hammer Bro's back. Can we yeet him? Which one's the yeet? Is that the yeet? That's not the yeet. There's more of them. I know another person who never rotates, so fair enough. I don't know what it is. Like, it just feels wrong. Oh, has he had a turn yet? Does this tell us who's next? Yeah, it does. Please tell me we can... Oh, he's got stun immunity! Goodbye, Crips! I think everyone dies now. Not just because Crips died, but just because there's a lot of them and not many of us. Let's do that one. Should we rotate? Should we run, sorry? Probably. Will we run? Probably. Oh, there's another one of them as well. We really should run. Leading arrow. Wait, which way is he facing? He's facing out that way. Well, it's there. I guess we'll just do that. Oh, whoops. Pressing the wrong buttons. We want to be up here. We want to do... Oh, no! Oh, I didn't realize I was that far away. We should have run. Oh, actually, he... Five! All big enemies have stun immunity? Yeah. I'm learning that, yeah. I probably should have realized that. Does this shoot diagonally? It doesn't, does it? Oh, new skills. Hold on, let's see what the skill is. Okay. Leading arrow. Come on. 3! Oh, bruh. Bleeding. What? I didn't realize he had another turn. We got away again. Somehow. I don't know if I misread that, the flea one. I thought it was 33% chance, but we seemingly have succeeded on that, like, every time. Oh, are these people high level, or is it just more expensive now? Let's get the Inquisitor. Well, we lost everything again. The ultimate survivor. Omega managed to survive all of it. This can be of Erendi. And Crips. Again. I'm not even gonna name that properly, it's just gonna be that. I wonder if it's broken or streamer luck for fleas. Oh, so you're actually not sure. You think that I might have just got lucky, or it could be broken? Okay, we don't have enough for that. So let's take. Oh, we don't have enough for that either. Just go down and die then, I suppose. Here we go. Love this game so much. The man who did it. Did an awesome job. Well, he's here in the chat today, so I'm sure he's would very much appreciate those words. But yeah, it's been pretty fun. Not gonna lie. We've lost so many times. We're not dead, though. We're sort of spiraling the drain. We really should have, like, yeeted out sooner. We've had so many occasions where we've been so close to being able to survive with our characters, but then we've just stuck around too long. Okay, oh, we can't get an arrow in there. Go from there, no. Go. Brap! Ooh, explosive. Oh, well, I can't very much do an explosive barrel with this fella, can I? Well, now he gets a turn. Piss! Just love to do it the boring way. Alright, go. 5 piercing, not bad. Give me the old stab and tickle. And parsnips! Parsnip crew is back, boys! Light it up. Parsnip crew, represent. Ducky is not my friend. Paid actor. I'm glad you clarified paid actor, because that would have hurt Ducky's feelings right there. Oof. They're not just paid to promote. The game's good, guys! I'm everybody's friend if you need one. Everyone needs a friend. Everybody needs a friend sometimes. So that is wonderful. Okay, well, this is less wonderful. Who's this? This is Omega. Omega's first again. I'm gonna do a sneaky shot in the back. Yeah. I'm gonna be Mr. Snicky. Here we go. 4. Yeah, probably wasn't worth it, was it? Let's get a stab off. Stab. So we can get him dead, but then he's going to attack someone, sadly. So he doesn't do too much damage. Adam got a shot. Legend of Zell, Subject Omega, watching his friends die slowly, painful death for PS5. That's actually my favorite title for the PS5. It's really, really solid gameplay, I find. Can we go all the way down here? I want to try something here. Can I do a headshot? Nope! A bean stick! Oh, we can do a shot here. I thought that one did, like, some piercing or something. It didn't. Well, maybe it does, but not from that range. Alright, give me the old slap and tickle. There we go. And... what? How much damage? 6 piercing. Okay, I think I'm gonna do that. Just because I need to not have them have another turn, basically. Okay, that's fine. Another one. Okay, my goal is to get through... We're gonna die. Is to get through this floor and then bail. Why can I not hit anyone? Here we go. Oh, that 7 damage is absolutely amazing. Gonna hide behind subject. Two damage, bruh. Oh, almost wasn't able to hit anyone there. Leading shot does more damage to enemies at full HP. Yes, correct. Correctamundo. Ow! Claire's getting slapped. I might just have to do... No, we'll do this. We'll do leading shot onto that person. 5, there we go. Pro tips, Subject Omega. Appreciate it, Omega. I know that you've played this game a lot of times. This definitely isn't the first time you've seen this game. Your professional tips help us to traverse this difficult landscape. Okay, we are gonna go headshot. There we go, 7 damage. Okay, the sharp arrow seems to be... Yeah, it only does 2. That does 3 and then more if they're healthy, but still 3. So I'll take that. Little morsel. Oh. Light him up. Nope. Oh, god damn it. I didn't realize I couldn't relight it if I clicked the wrong button. Rip. What's this? Free the logs! Oh, we have to get the logs. We have to attack. Oh my goodness. They're everywhere. Alright, headshot the club bandit. Gone. Boom! Omega. With the big damn. Thank you for the prayers. We're gonna need it.
All hail the great and mighty log.
Yeah. Omega survived because they know, listen to him? Nah. He's just got lucky. Okay, it's their turn now. Yeah, we certainly would not abandon Log, Adam. Don't you worry about that. We're gonna rescue him from these savages. For 3 log sprays, look. We're gonna need them. Especially after this fight. Alright, we can do a leading arrow on him to get that extra big damn. 5, not terrible. We're gonna go down here, do the old stab and tickle. Then I wanna get... Probably wanna do... What is the... Okay, piercing shot is a 1 to 2 range. And it does 6 piercing, so I think I need to do that, because that does 3. Okay, so I should be able to go... Let's go here. Yeah, because it does that. I don't want to hit crips again. Literally crips again. Okay. I'm going to use one of these because I cannot afford to take more damage. Because I want to try and nope out after this... After this conflict. 3 to 5, is that what? What's with the range with the headshot? It seems to be like a bit erratic. I'm sure there's like a specific reason for it, but it seems to be a bit all over the shop sometimes. Maybe we can actually escape one of these dungeons without losing everyone. And actually have, like, something to take home with us. Alright, we have a campfire. Who has the logs? Oh, wait, no, it's there. I'm just an idiot. Gather round, everyone! Gather round! Gather round the scrying pool! Okay. Oh, wait, does he have to come join? Yeah. I love that, who is this? Omega is just squatting over the corpse of one of the fallen enemies. Oh, look at that. We could keep going now. Those turkey legs. Damn, son. We're like almost back up to full health. No respect for the enemy. Just like actually teabagging. Just actually teabagging them after the fight. Alright, well. That was semi-intentional because I could have just gone down, but I wanted to see if there was anything else here. Now that we've done a heal, I didn't want to just leave and be like, well. I'm gonna use that to get the 3. Dude there. I just wanna see if there's... Yeah, that's the end of the room, that's fine. You can also leave during combat. Oh, like if we all stand on the pad, like on the thing, we can actually just leave? That's good to know. A whole new fight here, which is fine because we've just healed, so, and we've gotten our abilities like thing back, so we're all good on that front. can we make just Omega just leave, just have him yeet out, like he's like, nah guys, I've already fought in all of these engagements, I think I'm done. Leaves. Right. Stunt. I love how I have 12 silent shots. I'm expected to flank 12 times before I run out of other ammo. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. That ability seems pretty difficult to use. I'm sure there's like other things that make it more usable, especially even just like something that gives you more movement speed, but certainly at the moment it seems to be very tricky. Oh, I can't... Got no line of sight there. Alright, let's just get in with the old stab and tickle again. Boom. That's the last one. We've got another turkey leg. Okay, that was it. Now, will we push it one too far again? Will we make it one too far again? 11, 11, 14, and 13. We should just leave. We should. We're instantly into the big fight. Ultimate Survivor, Omega strikes again. Omega's just like... He's just down to clown. Alright, well, he does seem to be by himself currently. I'm sure we're about to get flanked by 20 other people, but... right now, we're in the clear. Piercing shot. 6 damage. And there we go. I knew it. Oh, they're stunned. Rude. Well, you know what? I can stun too. Bitch. There's another one. Another one. Bleed. Oh, and another one. I knew I should have left. I knew I should have. Oh, something to take. And stun. Let's do a headshot. Let's kill that big one. Oh my goodness. He survived with one. Everyone is stunned. Well, that's a yikes. He'll bleed out easy. Oh, he's got bleed on. Oh, I didn't even realize. Okay, we might be okay. It's not likely, but we might be okay. Somebody is going to die. Whoever that is, Claire is going to die. And Crips might also die again. Ooh, they're going to level up and heal. Right, let's do that one for the extra damage. Man, Omega is like seriously pulling his weight. What's this? Firestones? Deadly Switch? Guillotine? Let's go with that guillotine again. Because that's a bonus action, which means we can lean over and tickle this guy. Well, it's a bonus action, but it's like a ranged attack. Stab there. History repeats itself. Relax. Everyone's gonna make it home. I can't promise. I really can't promise that. Alright, we're gonna do that, because that gets a kill. Yeah, no, these two people are probably not gonna make it home. We can get a kill here, and it just means... this means that only one of you guys should die. Which is... actually, you know what? No, because we get the 7 there, and we get a stab here. Actually, fine. Actual big brain. Actually huge brain. Watch me now walk into another ambush. We really should leave. We're not going to get through the rest of this floor. No, no death. It's right, you survived. With tier 2 health, we can't make camp, I don't think so. Yeah. I think we should quit while we're behind. Yeah, that's probably true. I think we leave. Because it's not a flee if we're not in combat. So we do actually come out on top with that. Omega still hasn't got to level 3 after all of that. Claire got to level 2. Crips is level 1. But yeah, no level 3. We need some better armor. Ooh, is that better? It's a common two-handed bow. 2-6 range. Pulls the enemies closer instead of further away. I don't think it's better though. That headshot is pretty legit. Shuck's still in level 2. I mean, you're close. You close? Oh, you know what? Actually, we can buy this for Adam. We can give it to Adam. What is that? Old idol. If background is Wanderer, do we have a Wanderer? No, I don't think so. Buy some log. Parsnip gang! We did it. Save to menu. There we go! That is, unfortunately all we really have time for. We could delve into another one, but this is sort of when we're supposed to start wrapping up the stream anyway, so I don't want to cut ourselves off. Yeah, that was Netherguild. Adam will scream get over here every time he uses the pulling arrow. Yeah, and then you can push them away with your yeet arrow. It'll be perfect. Oh, look, a cemetery. Yeah, no, that was just our fallen comrades. It wasn't a cemetery. That was just what was left. Game was cool. Good work. Yeah, it was good. Thank you for checking out Netherguild. Don't buy it. Don't buy it. Just enjoy it from a safe distance. Don't buy it. Why would you say don't buy it? Yeah, that's all that I have time for in the stream tonight. Well, I'll stick around and chat for a little bit, but reverse psychology. I was actually gonna say that. There we go. There it is. There you go. Thank you, Adam. Already on top of it. From what I've seen, correct me if I'm wrong, but it's like $10 US. So for us, it's like $13, $14 or something. $10? Not too shabby. And I'm assuming there's going to be, you know, a decent amount added. It was, it's still in early access. And there's stuff to be tweaked and updated, so yeah. I enjoy it. $14.50. Okay, there we go. $14.50 Australian dollar it is. That's not bad. It's very cheap, but I will increase the price throughout early access as more content is added. Exactly. So, you want to get in there now, while it's really cheap. So that when the stuff gets added, the extra stuff gets added, you get that for free. Boom. There you go. Boom. Basically, it's a steal now, but will slowly be more expensive. Yeah. Exactly. Get it now. Get it while it's hot. Get it while it's still got stuff to be added. I mean, that being said, obviously, I mean, it's not going to be like, I'm assuming it's not going to be like, you know, oh, now it's super expensive because you're adding more content. So it's, you know, scaling with the amount of content, the amount of cost and stuff like that. But if you want to future-proof it and be like, yep, I trust that this game is going to be even better eventually once we've gone through the early access phase, now's a good time to get in. Now's a good time to get in. Later it's gonna be dollar, dollar, dollar. Looks fun as hell even in this state. Yeah. No, it was good. I hope to see you check out the new areas though. Yeah. Stream-wise, we do have like, we have a bunch, like the Wednesday slot, because Wednesday is like the main, is the slot that we have these new indie games on showcase, and we cycle about around a bunch of different things, so it's often fairly full, and if we can fit other stuff in, we will come back to games that we really enjoy, but there are a few other ones that I've really enjoyed as well, so they will be in there yeah, it would be nice to revisit for sure. Where you can visit Sparta people off a cliff. Oh, okay. Now you've got my interest again. I like that. I mean, yeeting them for miles with that bow and everything was already fun. So that yeah, that should be fun. And we know that makes Twitch handle. The Twitch maker's handle. Oh, the maker's Twitch handle. I know, I can read. I can read. We'll get there eventually if we stop dying. Yeah, eventually. The problem is we keep circling back to square one. We haven't really made much progress. But we're learning, I guess. Understandable. I'll ping you when I release a big update then. Yeah, please do. Genuinely, please do. Because that also gives me another... Like... Yeah, I try and cycle through different... like indie titles so we can get some nice showcases of stuff. And like I said, I'll always play stuff again when there's slots of things that I really enjoyed. But there's certainly a bigger argument to be made for ones that have had like big updates added that we can go and revisit them and see where they're at and how they're playing and stuff. So yeah, absolutely. Get in contact with me again. Yeah. For anything like that. Just send me a message. Like, I'm always on my DMs. We'll make him review it. Yeah, well, I've been debating whether I do, like, actual YouTube videos, like, proper... Like, actual, like, shorter form reviews rather than just the stream VODs. But the problem is I just don't have really much time. Shield shove was hilarious. Would be fun to use that to shove people off cliffs. That... Yeah. I love environmental... like, environmental attacks. Like, when I was playing... Like, there's all sorts of different games that you can play, but when I was playing Assassin's Creed Odyssey, not on stream, but I played that by myself, my favorite thing to do was to do quite literally the Sparta kick, yeeting them off the sides of massive buildings and just watch them fall to their death. Always fun. But yeah, it just before we go to the schedule part, I know Adam's already put it in the announcements. I'll run through it in a second. But Mr. Supero Bot, if you are still here, if you have anything else to say, the floor is yours. If you have anything else to mention about the game, like if you want to. Links, or if you want to, I don't know if you can, well, actually you can't post links, to be fair, because only mods can post links, but if you have stuff that you want people to check out, or you know where the game is and stuff like that, obviously it's on Steam, but if you have anything else that you want to say, just say it now and then we'll start the wrap up. Thank you a lot for the stream. I had a lot of fun. I enjoyed my stay and for the feedback. Wow, it was a pleasure to have you. It's always really, like, we've done a bunch of these and we've had about, I think we've only had two of them where the devs have come along, and when the devs have come along and just hung out and like told us stuff about the game and everything, it's always been, it always helps the experience. Even if the game is already good, it just, it's so much nicer having the dev there to just chat with and explain stuff and, you know, to give feedback to and stuff like that as well. It's, yeah, I love it when the devs are able to actually rock up and hang out. You can follow me on Twitter. Yeah, if anyone wants to add him on Twitter, there it is. At David Code and Art. Here we go. Game will release in full... We're releasing full release in a few years likely as well, but for now a ton of content already. Yeah, for sure. Keep an eye on it. Well, I think that leads me to schedule, which Adam has already put, but I will just reiterate over it for anyone that didn't catch it in the chat as well, and for anyone that's new. I am a variety streamer. I do different things throughout the week. Tonight was our sort of indie showcase, is what it's basically turned into at the moment, where we're running through a few different games. Tonight, obviously, Netherguild. Next week, we're playing Battle Shapers, which is like a rogue-lite first-person shooter. Kind of feels a little bit Overwatch-y in the way that it plays. I think we've got a demo of that. I think it's in early access as well. Interested to play that. Should be fun. I played a little bit of it off stream just because I was curious about a few things. So I broken the seal a little bit, which I don't usually do, but we'll get a proper run of it next week. Tomorrow, no stream. I don't stream on the Thursdays. So we're taking the run. Go home and have a beer or something. I don't know. I'm not your dad. Do what you want. Have a relaxing time. Just have fun, and we'll be back on Friday. Friday, we're going to be back with some more Starship Troopers. Starship Troopers Extermination. We'll be playing with Aaron again like we did last week. And we're going to squash some bugs. If you guys have the game, if you guys are interested, you can play with us. You can jump in and you can play along and squash those bugs with us. That is always, always good fun. I acknowledge. See you next time. No worries, Omega. Thanks for being here in the stream. It was a pleasure to have you here. I hope you enjoyed it. Yeah, Friday. And then we've got Saturday. We'll be doing some more Mass Effect 3. Playing the campaign through on that. With, I think we're only like one session in. It's the bigger 4-hour stream on the Saturday. We start 2 hours early on the 7 p.m. So make sure to show up for that. Those have been fun. They've been a little bit quieter, I think, just because of the game that it is. But I've been enjoying having the longer stream and being able to just chill and play through that game, which I haven't played through 3 before. So that's been fun. Sunday, nothing on the Sunday. We don't do streams on the Sunday. Unless there are extenuating circumstances. We miss a day and we go on Sunday. Anyway, then we go back to the Monday. We're going to be playing XCOM Enemy Unknown. All you guys are in there and you're definitely not dead. And I'm sure you won't die. So, thumbs up for that. And then Tuesday, that would lead us to Fallout 3 again. Last night we did the Pit DLC all in the one night. And we found the most broken weapon in all of Fallout. That thing is wild. We got quite stuck for a while and quite a bit annoyed. But we managed to sort it out in the end. We went to a 3-hour stream because we were just taking so long to figure that out. But yeah. And then yeah, of course Wednesday, Battle Shapers. I did enjoy. Good to hear. Good night, Claire. Good night. I'm going to raid out, so if anyone wants to stick around, even just for some bits. Drongo is the only one live by the looks of it, so I'm going to have to raid him 2 nights in a row. He's playing Norland. I don't know what that is. So let's go and find out. Everyone jump in. Go say hi to Drongo. Share some love. He's a fellow Australian streamer. If you haven't been here before, if you haven't been in a Drongo raid, he's a delightful lad that plays all sorts of things. He was playing some Skyrim recently, doing some permadeath runs. He had an AI mod on, which was hilarious, in one of them, where he could actually talk to his companion, and they had like an AI. It was quite interesting. But he's playing Norland at the moment, so go say hi. Let's go! Have a great day! I will. Thank you as well, Dis Ducky, for showing up. I appreciate it. I hope you enjoyed. Alright, I'll see you guys tomorrow. No, I won't. False. I'll see you on Friday for some bug stomping. Otherwise, next week for some Battle Shapers. Stay fresh, cheese bags!